problem with this city right there. Bloody nose.
Stay sharp, yeah?
Miss Attaway.
Yes, may I? Oh. Splendid. You're here to murder me.
I what?
No matter. Everyone has a price. Is this enough?
I'm not here to kill you.
And what's your game?
Mr. Starrick and the Milner Company have blocked your ambitions long enough. I have a business proposition for you.
Wonderful. Come with me. We have much to discuss, Mr.
Jacob Fry. At your service.
Truer words were never spoken.
If you'd be so kind as to take the reins. You must understand I've received threats against my life. Malcolm Miller has all but waged war on me since Mr. Starrick brought out his people. And no offense, I hope, but you do look the killer type.
I doubt I shall ever recover from such a slight.
What then is your intentions?
I sense an opportunity that will benefit us both.
Do you?
Is that so hard to believe?
Whatever your intentions, it will be quite the tonic to strike back against Milner and Starrick. I have worked like a trooper to make that way transport what it is. That's one of Milner's.
Keep moving.
I can't lose another bus.
Who's a good horse? You are. Slow down! Walk on, girl.
Malcolm Milner. Starrick's puppet himself.
Careful, you twats! This park scene needs to make it to the Attaway Depot.
He thinks he can burn my buses. Let's give him a taste of his own medicine.
Let's give him the whole damn bottle. We'll turn Milner's park scene against him. But I'll need help from my gang.
Such entrepreneurial instinct, Mr. Fry. I shall leave you to it.
She has the right to compete with us. Why does he want us poisoning our horses? Wouldn't it be better to see him?
Milner has enough horses. Besides, Attaway can prove a theft. She can't prove poisoning.
Right. Just a shame the horses have to get drawn into this.
Heave ho, Jacob.
Devil take you. If the police don't take the body, the rats will.
Primed and ready.
Plummeting already. You're hired. Oh, I have your business plan for us both. Drop a note to my secretary to make an appointment, and I shall reveal the next step in our scheme.
I don't actually work.
Like that.
No!
Miss Fry, what a pleasant surprise.
Hello, Clara. I was just going to check on Lambeth since the asylum's closing. What brings you here?
The children in my care have been falling ill. Our usual tonics aren't working. A cane, too.
Are you certain you're feeling all right?
Of course. I am, miss.
Clara! Is there a doctor nearby?
Bring her inside. She simply collapsed?
Yes, she said the others took tonic, but it didn't work.
I should think not. Ever since Elliotson was murdered, the district has been overrun with counterfeit tonics. This one needs proper care. But without the appropriate medication, she and the others will quickly decline.
What do you need?
I need supplies. Plenty of them. And medicine. Some of the less common ingredients are being stolen and sold at auction.
I'd be happy to help.
Here's the list. Miss
Fry.
Evie Fry. I'm Miss Nightingale. How do you do? Please hurry. We don't have much time.
Good work. I could use your help.
Stop! thank you enough. These supplies are meant for Miss Nightingale.
I'm here to collect them.
And they're already loaded on the cart. Please take them.
Giddy up!
You mean that cart?
Yes.
Of course it is.
Please be careful. Some of those items are fragile.
Not a moment too soon. I hope you brought the medication I requested.
How is she?
She will recover.
Babylon Alley, the children.
Thanks to you, we can distribute authentic medicine now.
But is that a permanent solution?
I will petition to have regulations put in place.
Lambeth is in your debt.
It takes a long time to change things. But I'm not going anywhere, Miss Fry.
dear, is that what you're wearing?
Miss Fry, very happy to see you. Your knife
Evie,
is
do be careful with that sharp blade.
I'd like to thank our esteemed guests.
So the hints you found in the Kenway House lead to the monument.
What a wonderful use of your time. Follow me around asking obvious questions.
Well, since Henry isn't here, I thought you might enjoy the company.
I don't require any company. And Mr. Green is following up on some leads of his own.
Oh, yes, Mr. Green. That's a fascinating idea. Oh, please, Mr. Green, come and take a look at this book and stand oh so close to me, Mr. Green.
I do not. Well, perhaps you have nothing better to do, but I'm busy protecting the assassins.
Are you really? What was it Father used to say?
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission.
Precisely. Anyway, I'm off. If I find any more wild geese for you to chase, I'll be in touch.
Be ever more pleasant for your absence.
Safer housing, sanitation facilities, and less open play.
What a racket! You sound like a bunch of children! You are being very ungrateful! Do you really want to keep living in fire traps? Well, we cannot continue this until you calm yourselves.
I'm taking a shot!
We are gathered here at the monument to the Great Fire, in an effort to ensure so great a tragedy will never happen again. I would like to thank our esteemed guests, the Right Honourable Premier de Grey, members of Parliament and others, for being here today. Our proposed legislation will ensure that housing for the impoverished need not be a fire hazard. We have heard your concerns. There is no need for shouting. Please calm down. There's no need for all this disruption. Too many today live in what are little better than hovels. In crowded conditions near open flame, and with few methods of fire control. Will you please stop shouting? You are only being moved out of your home if it is unsafe. Please, show some respect for our guests. Our new proposal will ensure that these...
This looks familiar.
Thank you.
It's in the very top. The key to the vault, and the shroud.
Good day, Miss Fry. I'll take that.
You want the shroud to cement your own power. But what if you cannot control it?
And why do you want the shroud? Merely to keep the Templars from having it? How like an assassin, to hold the power of eternal life, and yet be too afraid to use it.
Eternal life? Is that what you think the Shroud offers?
What I think is no longer your concern.
Coming with me?
I have other plans.
Damn it!
Thank you.
on our way.
Have some work for you.
All right then.
That'll be all. Thank you.
Yeah, of course. Walk on, my beauty.
Mr. Fry, I told you to make an appointment.
My schedule was open.
You're fortunate I like you.
Internal combustion engines.
Eight small syllables that mean a great deal of money. The engines will be delivered to Milner by train. Secure them for me, and he will be devastated.
I'll need a second train to pull this off. And I think I know just the man.
So we have a deal, Mr. Fry?
You're fortunate I like you, Miss Attaway.
So, what do you want, Fry?
What makes you so sure I want something? Perhaps I saved you out of the kindness of my own heart. Come on, let me tell you about the job.
Milner's pulling a lot of cargo there.
Just be sure to make the transfer.
Give him help.
We don't have all day. Get cracking.
This one.
The internal combustion engine. The end of horse-drawn transport. It's like gazing into the future.
And what is the going rate for the future, do you think?
We're not selling them.
You're giving them to your contact?
You'd be paid all the same.
Who is this Pearl, anyway? How long have you been working with her?
She's a business partner. That's all you need to know.
Jings, I hope I didn't make it to la-di-da. Slap some gold leaf here and there. I gave the wood a splash of shellac. Upholstered the lot. And how do you like the lampshades?
did you, Jacob?
Dressed in sartorial splendor.
Miss Fry, I brought some books. I hope I'm not intruding by being here.
Quite the contrary. It's nice to have the company. A herbarium? Are you collecting flowers for someone?
Only myself. I'm told it's something of a British pastime. Did you know, they all have symbolic meanings?
I had heard something of the sort.
Of course you have. Unfortunately, I have no time to fill the book.
I could collect some samples, if you would accept my help.
I would appreciate that. Thank you, Miss Fry.
I'm told Dr. Elliotson came to a bad end.
Mignonette, your qualities surpass your charms.
I'm not entirely sure that's meant as a compliment. Love in a Mist. That's a pretty name.
Alternatively called Devil in a Bush.
Narcissus. Self-love. I should buy a bouquet for Jacob.
Most unkind, Miss Fry.
As amusing as all this is, I really should be getting back to work. If you need me...
I'll send a bouquet.
Of irises?
A message. Indeed.
A Gurkha knife. Just like Father's.
Jacob, darling, do join me.
To our fruitful partnership.
And to the shiny new engines now in my possession. Back to business. Milner's fled to the Thames, occupied with securing his ferry. It's all he has left.
Protecting it with his life, no doubt.
The very thing I want you to take. Just kill him.
That's not your first glass of champagne, is it?
Success is more intoxicating than alcohol, Mr. Fry.
Then save a glass for me.
Now, what would it take to draw out Starek's pawn? The sight of his ferries in flames, perhaps. To sink Milner's enterprise.
Thank you. What the bloody hell?
Someone take care of this!
By all means. There must be something of interest here.
Thank you.
was supposed to watch over them. What do I pay you those for?
I knew this day would come. Mr. Starrett was furious I lost the engines. So this is my comeuppance.
Pearl Attaway led me to you, not Starrick.
And then we're gonna give her again. I should never have come between Mr. Starrick and Miss Attaway. Family always stay together in the end.
What do you mean, they're family?
Time for Pearl and I to have a real conversation. There you are. What are you up to now, Pearl?
The Order and was there to end me. Imagine my delight when he told me his true purpose. An assassin helping the Templar cause. Isn't that delicious?
It's sickening.
It's business, cousin. Look at the big picture. With Milner gone, I own the only omnibus company left in London. We already have a monopoly on English transportation. The moment your engines power my buses...
You glower too much, cousin. You will get your engines back. Our new motorized buses will bring us both a lot of money.
I'll need to arrange proper transport for the engines to get back to my factory. I want you at Waterloo, personally, to ensure that nothing goes wrong.
Of course. May the Father of Understanding guide us.
Today and in all of our future endeavors, cousin. Waterloo Station.
Door's jammed.
Again? Just give it a shove.
Not wasting my time
anymore. Drag him out! Stay away!
Thank you.
pistols at the ready!
I found you, boy! Ready to shoot! Clear above!
Sir, the engine's just pulled into Waterloo. Once Starrick's men arrive, they're gonna unload the train.
Well, not if the train has already left. Assemble a team at Charing Cross. I'll send the engines there for you to recover.
Mr. Fry?
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I apologize for the delay. We will get you into the central station very soon.
When the hell is that scheduled?
Central station's closed. Attaway's orders.
You saw these blueprints, did you not? Were you aware of this floor?
It's only a minor weakness. The final wagon's otherwise fortified.
Come on, Chief, where are you? Once the order comes through, we will send you on your way to the central station.
I need to get to the central station.
You and this whole lot. It won't happen until I have my train notices.
Once the order comes through, we will send you on your way to the central station. My colleague should be here shortly with the schedule for the central station. We thank you for your patience.
Happened an handful of times.
We'll talk about this later. Just keep your mouth shut from now on.
We will send you on your way to the central station. My colleague should be here shortly with the schedule for the central station. We thank you for your patience.
Thank you.
Attention, passengers. All trains are being diverted to Central Station. I repeat, make your way to Central Station for departures.
Get out of our way.
What's going on? The station chief is usually punctual.
I'm going to miss my train.
Thank you.
I don't like the look of these arseholes.
Oh, yeah.
Have to run. Someone's bound to find you.
You won't be stirring up no more trouble.
That looks like my...
or make eye contact.
I don't require a reason to end your life. Make a sound, and it'll be your last.
What a shame. Good partnerships are hard to come by.
Ours is most certainly dissolved.
It's business, Mr. Fry. One does what one must to come out on top. Crawford will not take the news of my death lightly. He can be unpleasant when he's cross. I have sacrificed so much. I don't want to lose my buses.
When coldness or deceit shall slight the beauty now they prize, and deem it but a faded light which beams within your eyes. When hollow hearts must wear a mask.
Mr. Starrett.
I told you not to disturb me!
Till break your own to see.
In such a moment I would ask that you remember me. That you remember me.
Crawford.
A luster stripped by the hands of that savage. He must be brought to justice.
Pearl would not want justice. Pearl would want vengeance.
Your passion is most welcome, Miss Thorne. But we cannot let our emotions disrupt the lawful structures of society. If we do that, the enemy wins.
It shall happen in the shadows. Miss Fry will hang from the gallows, and I will flay her brother as he comes to save her.
I suppose it must be done. Take no chances. Increase the Templar presence in London. We alone protect this City of Light.
Yes, Crawford. And then we shall enter the vault and cast aside the shadows together.
What have we here?
Boiler, this Dredge character's meddling will be the death of us. He was loitering around the exchange today, asking far too many questions about the bank. Should he discover my plan, you will face a far worse fate than losing your job. Signed, Plutus.
So this Plutus is Starek's banker, hmm? I wager Dredge will lead me to him.
While you're out and about, do attempt not to destroy modern medicine or the London transportation network.
Don't make me laugh.
Innocent lives hang in the balance. They depend on the city.
I'm not the one who let Lucy Thorne walk away.
A mistake I intend to rectify immediately.